Hey guys, it's your man Blue Rapid, and today we are looking at the new Kingdom Hearts 3 trailer that just came out earlier today, or earlier this morning, at some point in this 24-hour period. This trailer, in my opinion, came out at a good time and a bad time. For those of you who are unaware of what has happened in the last week or so, there has been the release of the PlayStation 4 limited edition for Kingdom Hearts 3, which I did get, but we'll get into that a little bit more after the trailer. But also, somebody apparently stole a bunch of copies from either like Walmart or something. I've heard mixed things here and there of where the copies came from, but like the copies were taken and sold online, and spoilers have been unleashed upon the world, and yet they're like, here's a trailer. Yeah, like, it's not like the game's out already, but which is another thing I'm going to get into after the trailer, because I'm really hyped about seeing this, because out of all the trailers that we've received in the last few weeks or months or so, they've been pretty short, and this one's a hefty trailer. It's like 4 minutes long, which I'm like, bro, that's a heck of a trailer you got there. And I'm not going to complain, especially if it has some good stuff. But I've heard this and that, but I don't want to say anything until after I've seen the trailer. So, without further ado, let us hop into this, because it's late. I have things I need to do, and I want to see it. I just want to see it. Yeah. And for those of you who have noticed, I am feeling a little bit better. My voice is slightly back. It is still kind of groggy if I don't force it, but I am feeling better. So for those of you who are like, I hope you feel better, Blue Rapid, which none of you did. How dare you? How dare you? But I do feel better, and let's get started.
They can take your world. They can take your heart. Cut you loose from all you know.
What the heck? It keeps cutting in and out. I'm like,
then every step forward will always be a step closer to home.
I'm not even sure what this man just said. I was so distracted by what I'm seeing, but it's... Oh, I love the song. Buzz, no! Uncle Scrooge! Oh my god, that scene made me sad. Ooh! Get him, Sword! Stitch? Yeah, I heard about Stitch. Oh! I heard about this too. A new Keyblade? Oh snap! Oh, get him, Sora! Get him! Oh my god, look at the Heartless are just so massive!
So tomorrow, you and me in the ring. You ready? Don't hold back, Lee. Promise?
I want you for ah!
Wait! Find the hearts joined to yours.
Bruh!
I would hate to think we invited you back into our ranks, only for you to fail to deliver our final vessel.
I'm scared.
Join your heart
with mine!
Just where are we supposed to be looking?
There's so much!
The war is upon us.
Ah!
Haven't you already learned how to restore someone's heart after it's been lost?
Sounds like Kyrie, Digimon.
New purpose.
Kari.
Kyrie's right. We're all in this together, Sora.
Please, I have created enough victims. All of the children sacrificed in the name of your research.
Oh, that's Ansem?
There's a high price to pay.
I like that.
For wielding such power foolishly.
So what?
There's no saving you. Are you?
Oh. I feel conflicted. I saw something, but I'm not sure I saw. No! No!
Sora, you don't believe that. I know you don't.
What did I just see? What madness is this?
Once a seat of power for all Keyblade wielders, here I and my other selves can be one. In Scala et Kylo.
What? 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 No! No! You monsters! You can't do this to me! Okay, so, several things happened in that trailer that make me mad, they make me happy, they make me just... First things first, there was a lot that happened. There was a lot of good, there was a lot of sad things, one of which, if you noticed, you're seeing a little bit more of Ventus. I did look back through a little bit, and it was definitely Ventus when Sora got grabbed by the chain, and then up came somebody that looked like either Roxas or Ventus. It was Ventus. I saw the little shoulder thing. Another thing that I don't like is the fact that, like, now that we brought you back into our ranks, I'm just like, who did they bring? Because, you know, part of me was like, is it Axel? Is it Axel? He's like, I miss my best friend. No, I don't think it's Axel. I don't think it was Axel. And while on the subject of, well, Lee, I did see, like, someone talking about how, like, the same thing both Shion and Kairi said the same thing, don't hold back, okay? And when Lee looks at Kairi, he sees Shion, and I'm just like, oh, God, it is happening. It is happening. Where, because a lot of people are like, oh, Shion's gonna come back. And I was like, why would Shion come back? I thought she was one of those things that, like, she was a memory, but not a memory, because once she's gone, the memories are gone too, but only fragments are left behind. I feel conflicted. I enjoy it. I enjoy it a lot. I feel conflicted. Ibuski. I did like the fact that we see, is it Replica Riku or is it Data Riku? Because, I think it's Replica Riku, but him and the real Riku are facing off. I like that. But it did feel a little bit sluggish because he was like, eh, hit, eh, hit, eh. And I was like, what happened to that speed we saw in Kingdom Hearts 2 against Ansem? Which, not Ansem, Xemnas, which he does use that ability against Lee, which I'm like, bruh, so many people are falling. Like, Donald fell. I am blowing up at you guys. I am sorry. There was just so much in that trailer that I just completely, I need this game. I need it. Which brings me to my my point I was making earlier about someone stealing like 30 or so copies of the game. I, for one, I think it's understandable that, like, fans were to do this. It's like one of those things that, like, I expected it, but I wasn't really expecting people to actually do it. Like, you know, it's like, you know, if you're desperate enough, I expect somebody to steal it. But I wasn't expecting 30 copies to be stolen and sold on the internet for others to buy and spoil for everybody else. Thanks, you're dicks. You're dicks. It's official. You're dicks. Your mama doesn't love you. She's not a nice lady. Yeah, I said it. Eh. But at the same time, if someone came up to me and was like, yo, you want to buy Kingdom Hearts 3 right now? And it was like, tomorrow someone did this. I'd be like, you're going to have to come with me to my place and let me install it onto my machine to make sure it is the real deal. Like, I need to be able to say for certain I am paying whatever fee it is. And if it is legit, I'd be willing to pay a hefty amount. Not too much, because I've already bought quite a bit for this game. Like, if they said 80, 90, maybe even 95, I'd say, give it to me. Just give it to me. I'm willing to do it. But if they're like 200, 250, 300, I'd be like, you have lost your mind. See, I've already bought the PlayStation Pro. That's $400, and it already comes with the game. I got the deluxe edition, which is about $80, before adding into the coupons that I have collected for this very occasion. I did. I've hoarded coupons. I was like, boom, there we go. But I'm also thinking of getting the digital copy so that when it's released at midnight, I'm able to not only stream it right away, but able to enjoy the greatness. Because I'm hyped about it, but I'm not willing to pay that much money to get another copy that I'm going to get at some point. And some people, like, I feel like would pay $300 just to get this game. And for that, I applaud you, but don't be a dick and show it to the world. Don't do that. Don't be that person. Don't spoil the content. Don't be coming to other people's feeds and be like, yo, Donald dies at the end. Just saying. I'd be like, you're banned from the Kingdom Hearts community. You are no longer welcome in Kingdom Hearts at all. And on the subject of the PlayStation, for those of you who do not know, it did get released at a weird time. It was released early in the morning. No one was aware of its release, as far as I'm aware. No one told me. I saw it randomly on IGN. I was actually content with my life, thinking I'm never going to get this PlayStation 4. And then suddenly when I get home, I see it on Facebook and I just lose my mind. I go to find it, only to find out it's sold out, but it's not sold out. You have to actually go to the store, which is another thing. You have to go to the store apparently to buy this thing. And it's not pre-order, according to what I was told. You have to buy the entire console. You have to put up $400 on the spot, and they will then be like, yep, it's coming to your house at some point. In the next week after its release. I don't know. But I do find it interesting because I don't think the trailer was supposed to be released today. I think it was supposed to be released tomorrow or something. Because I could have sworn it was supposed to be either sometime later on in the week or something. But I'm happy that we're seeing it. It's a hefty, hefty trailer. So that makes me really happy. There's so much that happened. And I felt it was more sad. Especially Sora at the end, it looked like he was giving up. And Riku was like, no, you don't give up. You don't give up. And I was like, you tell him, you get your buddy back up with your hefty freaking keyblade that makes no gosh darn sense at all. None. But one interesting thing is that we do hear more of the new voice of Xehanort. And once again, I miss the original Xehanort's voice. It's not the same. It really is not the same. And I was really, really hoping that we would hear, like, cause they said they got all of his lines done. So I don't know. It sucks that he's gone now. And so we can't get that raspy voice. Like I'm almost at his level of raspy. I think I'm saying that word right. But like, it just sucks that he's gone. It does. It sucks. But I was like confused at the end. I was like, wait, whoa, what? Like, there's this huge town and there's these people floating in the sky. I'm just like, I just don't know what to do, people. I don't know what to do. And I'm just like, I need your help. I need somebody to talk to express myself on this subject because there's just so much. There's just so much and it's so beautiful. It really is. I can't wait to play this game. But before I go and let my insanity continue for this game, once again, I feel like they're showing us too much. Like, I pray that's not the real ending. Like, that's not the final battle. Because that's what they say. That's what it says. It's the final battle trailer. Like, I don't want that to be spoiled for me. I wanted to go into that. Not knowing what's going on. Like, don't get me wrong. I have no idea what's going on. None. None whatsoever. But I have a good idea. And I still don't like it. I don't like the fact that I have a decent idea of what's going on. I wanted to go into this game completely blind. I wanted to be like, wait, what? What? What's going on? What's going on? Oh, my God. Like, I wanted to be able to react like I did for this trailer for the game. But, you know, I'm still going to react that way because I have a short attention span. I don't even remember half the stuff I saw. So by the time the game comes out, I probably won't truly remember. So I feel good. I feel good, I think. Kind of. Who knows? But tell me what you guys thought in the comments down below. Did you guys enjoy this trailer? Did you think my reaction and my explanation was just a little over the top? Let me know, because I do like to discuss these sort of things with you. Not so much my reacting, but yeah, I don't mind talking with you guys. Yeah, it's fun. But hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, make sure you press that like button and share with your friends so that they can enjoy it too. And if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Tumblr so you can stay up to date on all my activities, whether it be YouTube, Twitch, or just random stuff to make you guys laugh, because that's what you're here for. So hopefully I'll see you guys next time. But until then, deuces.